dear students, of class 9 A, class 10 A or 10 B, this topic, the Quit India Movement. The few points I would like to analyze further for your better understanding. What is the impact of the Quit India Movement? What was about the impact of Quit India Movement? I am going to discuss about it. Quit India Movement had left certain impacts. Number one, the movement, although was started under the leadership of Gandhiji, and people also have become a part of this movement. People of different communities of India, almost all, they took part in this movement. They had become an active role in Quit India Movement, because Quit India Movement was the last movement as per Gandhiji's opinion. That's why Gandhiji gave a call, do or die. But Quit India Movement made a great impact in the country because of people's direct participation in this movement. Second one, the British government realized that the shifting of their proposal or their demand for shifting power for the Indians, they were unable to accept. But during Second World War, the British declared it that India was at war with Germany. The rulers wanted to insult the country India, and it was due to that reason the Congress leaders who were in the ministry, they all resigned from ministries in protest against that act of misery, because the British wanted to get involved the soldiers of India in the Second World War. But they did not think that that matter should have been discussed with the Congress leaders, since they were with them in the ministry. That's why Congress resigned the ministry. As soon as Congress resigned from the ministry, the Muslim League was cheered up, because they wanted to, they had been expecting that the situation would come, the Congress leaders would resign from the ministry and they would not be part of British ministry. So the situation came. Another one, the proposal of Free Commission could not fulfill the needs and expectation of the Muslim League, because Muslim League was in favor of a country, separate country for the Muslims named Pakistan. But there was no assurance of giving, of making a separate country for the Muslim Pakistan. Hindu Mahasabha also rejected it. So everyone rejected the proposal of Peace Mission. Peace Mission's main proposal was to grant the dominion status their former demand, but Gandhiji did not want to accept it, because their main demand already they had produced before them was do or die, karenge ya marenge, shifting of power or complete independence instead of dominion status. But the British did not want to accept the demand of complete independence but dominion status, and hence Gandhiji strengthened the temperament of Quit India movement. That's why Quit India movement became a great movement throughout the country. Everywhere there was protest against the British repression, because in protest against the Quit India movement, the British wanted to crush the movement by hook or by crook. That's why the British arrested so many innocent people, including Mahatma Gandhi and his followers. They all remain in the jail. But besides Mahatma Gandhi and his followers, so many innocent people also were arrested. And the policy of repression also created an atmosphere fish out of water. That's why, my dear student, it was due to the effort of Gandhiji, it was due to the effort of other Congress leaders, the Quit India movement had become short-lived. A very short-lived movement, Quit India movement had become short-lived. And next one, underground movement. Under the leadership of Aruna Asaf Ali, Jayaprakash Narayan, the underground movement also was going on. That means, in protest against the repressive work of the British government, the Congress leaders who were in the jail, the other leaders like Jayaprakash Narayan, Aruna Asaf Ali, they kept on continuing underground movement. Now, what is underground movement? A movement which was controlled from the underground, and the program of killing British officials by throwing bombs or by using pistol so that the British must be scared of the underground leaders. That's why underground movement continued. And the British government decided to suppress the movement at any cost. And at the time when the British government decided to suppress the movement, almost all people of India, they strongly supported the underground movement also. And at the time when the British government realized it, that they were going to do something, Jayaprakash Narayan openly declared that they would continue struggling, fighting against the British government, because their source of power was not like the British government, but whatever they were getting from abroad would help them to continue struggle against the British government. So with the help of foreign, revolutionaries living abroad, the underground movement had become very powerful, and Jayaprakash Narayan led the movement strongly. Besides, another point that was very important, the Socialist Party also gained popularity and became more and more powerful because of the negative role of the British. The British government did not want to accept the demand of complete independence, but under the 14 points of Woodrow Wilson, under the 11 points of Woodrow Wilson, one clause was there: at the end of the Second World War, all countries of the world who were under British control and where British established their colonies, they would be declared independent. So India also was a British colony. That's why India should have to be declared an independent country. That's why the British was determined, but the British was in a fix what to do, but they did not want to give the credit to the Indian Congress leaders. that they struggled, they continued struggling, they continued Quit India movement, do or die, that slogan that Britishers were compelled to shift power to the Indians. Britishers decided to crush the movement, ultimately it was crushed. Then the British government decided to do something better for the people of India in pursuance of the Woodrow Wilson's 14 points. What was it? Making the countries of Asia free from British control. India was one of it. So India must be independent. The British government kept it in their mind. Woodrow Wilson's 14 points. Meanwhile, you know, Labour Party's Prime Minister Winston Churchill sent Sir Stafford Cripps. The mission came but could not achieve success, got back empty-handed. And afterwards, the report of Cripps' mission made the British agree that something should be done in resemblance with the need of Woodrow Wilson's points. India must be given complete independence. The British must do something better for them. And next one, Jayaprakash Narayan and Aruna Asif Ali kept on doing anti-British works from time to time. The British government could not arrest them, but all the Congress leaders were arrested. And in course of time, one by one, all Congress leaders were released from the British jail. And afterwards, the Quit India movement was crushed. Although the Quit India movement was short-lived, but it had left vivid impression. It left certain impacts on the people and on Indian politics. The British government realized that the people of India were firmly determined to make their country free from British control. That's why, before shifting power for the Indians, the British arrested a number of Indian innocent people, including the Congress leaders and Mahatma Gandhi. But ultimately, they came to a conclusion that the Congress leaders should not be given credit, but the British deserved credit. The British, so that they must proudly proclaim that the India had become a country, the Britishers passed the movement, their last movement, Quit India movement, and then they shifted power to the Indians. Indians were unable to make them agree to shift power, but the Britishers shifted power to the Indians after having crushed the last movement, Quit India movement. It was due to the efforts of Gandhiji and other Congress leaders. They realized it, but they immediately wanted to make the country free from British control. Ultimately, Gandhiji and all other Congress leaders were released from jail, but they all remained silent. There was no movement, but underground movement under Jayaprakash Narayan and Aruna Asif Ali was continuing. Ultimately, the British government came to a conclusion the Indians should be given their independence, power should be shifted, and ultimately underground movement also was withdrawn. The British government decided to give to shift power to the Indians. Now how was it possible? How did they agree to shift power to the Indians? That points I shall discuss later in our next topic. Thank you, my dear students.